Hello, I am Gilles Salle from Lyon University Center, and I would like to comment with you a couple of new emerging strategies that came up from the ASCO and EHA annual meetings. We heard during this meeting the consolidated result or update of a couple of new agents that will be available, hopefully, in the next few years for patients with lymphoma. In the field of antibody-drug conjugate, we heard now the result of the phase 2 study of loncastuximab, also called Lonca, which is an antibody against CD19 coupled with a toxin which was used in diffuse large B-cell lymphoma. The overall response rate are in the range of 40-45%, and about 20-25% of the patients have achieved a CR, and the median duration of response was in the range of 10 months. So this appears to be a promising drug that may be beneficial for patients who had failed CAR-T or not eligible for CAR-T, and the new agents that will come up in the field. We heard also very early results from another antibody against CD47 coming from Korea with some interesting safety and efficacy, very early signals. But more broadly, there were a couple of results regarding the bispecific antibody that target both B cells and tumor cells, and which have a real interest for our patients. One of those was the glofitamab communications, which show now that more hundreds of patients have been treated. We have consolidated result of about 40% of response with 35% of CR in patients with diffuse large B-cell lymphoma, and an interesting result also for patients with indolent lymphoma, which appear to be stable over the time, at least for 1 year. The safety is also good, despite the fact that there are some CRS and neurotoxic events encountered in these patients. Another bispecific that was presented was epcoritamab, another bispecific antibody that can be delivered subcutaneously, which I believe could be interesting. These were early results with a very high response rate in patients with follicular lymphoma, but only 7 patients. Again, some cytokine release syndromes that need to be handled. Finally, during this meeting, we heard a long-term follow-up of the L-MIND studies, a combination of tafasitamab plus lenalidomide in patients with relapse or refractory DLBCL, expanding the results that were recently published in Lancet Oncology and showing that the duration of response that was seen earlier was consolidated. There was also the report of the comparison of this clinical trial with real-life data, a study called ReMind, presented by Dr. Novakovsky, showing that there was, in this historical comparison, a really significant and marked benefit of this combination of tafa-lenalidomide as compared to lenalidomide only. And we hope that these agents, summarized here very briefly, will be available for our patients and bring to them new options in the near future. Thank you for your attention.